Hey guys, welcome to the channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at a relatively recent release from G-Shock. I think it's pretty cool. This is the Carbon Core Guard. It's an affordable, again, a relatively new release. And I like it because it's pretty similar to what I consider the king, the 5610 or the classic square that debuted in the 1980s. Now this one was purchased by my friend Robert of the Random Rob channel. He reviewed it and featured it on his excellent channel. He sent it to me so that I can feature, and then he wants me to give it away to a youth in my neighborhood. I volunteer with the young men's group. We meet weekly, and it's something that I try to do on a fairly regular basis, is give gift watches to the young men. So we're going to be doing that at the end of the video, so stay tuned for that. But getting back to the Carbon Core Guard, this sells for about $99 right now, which is good. You know, it's affordable, it's accessible to a lot of people, and it carries a lot of the design DNA from the classic square that I think just makes it a fun release. Now let's compare the two side by side. You guys can see the design DNA, how it translates, how they kind of complement each other. The classic square has an octagonal bezel here, but it's a little bit elongated. It's more in the form of a rectangle. This carbon core guard has equidistant octagonal bezel here when it comes to the length of the sides. And I can hear a couple comments already saying, "That's a Royal Oak copy." Guys, it's really not. This is about as far from Audemars Piguet as you can get. It's very, very different. I think still carries dominant Casio G-Shock design DNA. A couple things to note though that I find interesting. We have a digital dominant display here on the classic square. On this new GA2100, you still have a digital display, but it's kind of tucked away down there by the 4 o'clock position. The dominant time display here is done with a classic hour and a minute hand, plus your applied markers. Now let's do some low light shots here and we'll do some comparisons. What I like about the new release is, yes, the digital display does light up, but you also have a secondary LED light that illuminates the dial, so you can still see those traditional hands and indices. It's not quite as bright as what you'd see here like on the 5610 or my Bling Master, the GMW B5000, which has a very potent LED light up with the fade transition. But you guys can see, like all G-Shocks, it's got a very good look in low light situations. Now let's zoom back out. We'll talk about a couple things. Now I love the classic square. I mean, this is my favorite G-Shock. I know there are a lot of great ones out there that appeal to thousands of people, but to me the cream of the crop is always going to be the classic square that debuted in the 1980s. I like this one, that the fact that it is solar powered, it's atomic syncing once a day, gets the signal from Fort Collins, Colorado, and auto adjusts to the correct time, you know, just absolutely accurate. The new Carbon Core Guard, it's not gonna have that. It's not solar powered, it is non-atomic time syncing. It's just a classic tough movement from Casio, and you will have to replace the battery every so often, depending on how much you use the light up feature and some of the other just options on the module. So what's the draw to this one then? You know, if it is non-atomic syncing and it does not have solar powered movement. Well, the feature is, I mean, it's cool, it's tough. I think it's a good looking watch, but the big draw is the price point. You know, they sell for right around $100 right now, which for the price is really hard to beat considering what you get. Now I'm gonna put a picture on the screen of a couple different options. And the red one looks, oh my gosh, that's my favorite. That one looks killer. I'd love to wear that on game day when my Utes are playing or my 49ers are playing on Sunday. That would be a very fun watch to have on wrist. Actually, I wear the Bling Master usually on Sundays if I'm doing a 49ers party or something like that. But it's kind of interesting that these beater watches, these G-Shocks that are tough and basically indestructible, we almost treat as fashion elements. Like, hey, yeah, I'm gonna wear this when I watch my favorite team play, or I wanna match my favorite shoes or hat. And I don't know, it might be kind of silly, but it's one of the draws to me. So anyways, the G-Shock Carbon Core Guard, the GA2100, it's an affordable new release. I think it's handsome. I think it would be interesting if Casio decided to give this the full metal treatment. Then you homage haters might have a little bit more of a leg to stand on when you call this a Royal Oak copy. But I think it's a fun release. I'm happy to highlight it on the channel. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed the little look into this model. Let me know if you have specific questions. I'll put some links here in the description where you can order these. Now let's get to the giveaway. I've decided to give this one to Sam. He's a young man in my neighborhood. He's an awesome young man. He's really, I think, gonna enjoy this watch. Very active. He's talented at basketball, handball. He's an Eagle Scout. He's always camping. And I think this watch will serve him well. He can get it wet. He doesn't have to take it off when he's playing basketball or volleyball or something. And it's gonna serve him real well. He has aspirations to become a civil engineer. So give Sam a big congrats in the comments. And I wanna thank you, Robert, my good friend, for doing that. Really appreciate that, man. So anyways, guys, that's a little look at the new release. Thanks for taking the time to watch. Reach out with questions, and I'll see you in the next video. Yeah. Okay. Hang on, guys. My daughter's knocking. Can you leave me be so I can film? No. Do you want to go downstairs and see Mom? GA2100. Did you poop? Yeah. Okay, can Mommy change your bum? Yeah. Okay, go get Mom. Daddy. You want me to change you? Yeah.